Good morning, ma'am. Good morning, everybody. I'm John Edward Delgado, and my group mates are Mr. Peralta, Mr. C, Mr. Banyas, and Mr. Bruce. We're glad to represent our group work. It's all about alternatives to imprisonment. So when we hear alternatives to imprisonment, it's any kind of punishment other than to imprisonment or jail that can be given to a person who commits a crime. Many issues related to institutional correction currently best many countries in the Asia Pacific region. For most of those is overcrowding of facilities. When we say many issues po, marami po sa countries ng Asia is nagkakaroon na ng problem or nagkakaroon ng problem sa overcrowding pagdating sa kanilang mga kulungan. Kaya po, nag-iisip sila ng alternatives way para hindi nadalhin yung mga minor offense or offender sa loob ng jail. Next po is yung facts state that are more people being sentenced to imprisonment but there are not enough prison facilities. Dito naman po is, sinasabi dito is, maraming ang person na nahatulan ng pagkakakulong. Pero po, yung mga prison facilities is not enough. Kaya po, nagkakaroon ng problem na overcrowding. Ano po ba yung dahilan bakit dumadami mga person na nakukulong? Because the increasing number of people admitted to prison is a result of increasing crimes, intensive war on drugs, effective police operation, and tighter prosecution. Ang sinasabi po dito, dahil sa pagdami or paglobo ng populasyon ng mga suspect or person na nakukulong, dahil din po dun sa double effort ng ating mga kapulisan, then syempre po yung tinatawag nating intensive war on drugs. So next po, this alternatives to imprisonment is to alleviate. When we say alleviate po, mababawasan or malessen natin yung problem pagdating sa overcrowding. Imprisonment may be considered as a last resort for first-time offenders and the most only for habitual or professional criminals. When we say, sinasabi po dito is, pag hindi naman masyadong malala yung nagawang offense ng person is, huwag na lang pundali ng jail para po hindi na magkaroon ng overcrowding. Ang erekta na lang po sa jail is yung mga person or suspect na habitual or professional criminals. In United Kingdom and United States, number one, absolute and conditional discharge. It means discharge given for the less serious offenses, such as very minor theft. It could be an absolute discharge, which means no punishment will be imposed because the experience of going to court has been punishment enough. So, ano po ba yung sabihin ng absolute charge? Is no further action is taken. Kumbaga, yung offense is minor lang. Or should I say, yung ginawang kasalanan ng isang tao is minor lang, but still, kakaroon pa din siya ng criminal record. Sa part naman ng conditional discharge, is that no further action is released unless magkakaroon ulit siya or magkakaroon ulit yung isang tao ng panibagong crime with a time decided by the court. No more than 3 years. Next po is yung binding over. The court may order a defendant to be placed in custody pending outcome of proceeding against him or her. Binding over means holding a person for trial or bond bail or in jail. If the judicial official who conducted hearing find probable cause to believe that the accused commit a crime, then the official will bind cover the accused setting bail. Ito naman yung tinatawag natin na precautionary measure na kailangan ma-adapt or adapt, especially when it comes to reasonable ground to anticipate some present o di kaya yung tinatawag natin na future danger. Well, ito ay hindi isang conviction or punishment. Kasi po, ito ay isa lamang order used to prevent certain behavior from occurring in the future. Next one is yung fines. Fines. For less serious offense committed by first-time offenders in more serious offense or where the defendant has a criminal record, many judges combine a fine with other punishment such as incarceration, community service, and probation. Hindi naman sigurong langid sa kaalaman ng marami or karamihan sa atin yung tinatawag natin na fine when it comes to a crime. And fine po is yung referring to a form of monetary punishment, syempre, for a crime or offense na nagawa or na-commit ng isang person. Yung amount po, unang fine can be determined case by the case. And some cases, there will a fine. And at the same time, may kahalong punishment pa din. Like, ayun nga, yung incarceration, community service, and probation. Next po is yung probation. What is probation? Probation, under this measure, offenders will be released, but they have to follow the condition fixed by the court and must be under the supervision of supervision officer for not less than 1 year and not more than 3 years. Sinasabi naman po dito sa probation is handed down by the judge in trial. Well, ito din po yung papalayain kung sino man yung may sala or nagkasala. But we will be a condition na kailangan niyang sundin. Sa part kasi dito na naglalas ang probation from 1 year to 3 years, but can extend and even up to life, depende sa kung anong type ng conviction. For example na lang is drugs and sex and etc. Next po natin is yung suspension of sentence of imprisonment. Putting prison time on hold provided the defendant complains with certain other obligation. Completion of drug treatment program. If the prosecution or probation department can convince a judge that the defendant violated the condition that led the sentence being suspended in the judge has authority to order the defendant to serve the original sentence. So, ang suspension of sentence of imprisonment or pwede din nating tawagin na suspended sentence ay kung saan sinisistensyahan ng isang judge yung defendant to jail or prison time, but then delays imposing the sentence, parang yung defendant will serve time on probation. Syempre sa suspended sentence kasi is typical means that means conviction will remain on a person criminal record. Committal to the care of a fit person. Committal to the care of a fit person. So in case the offender is less than 17 years old, the court may commit him to the care of person, could be relatives, school or orphans, or orphanage, who is deemed fit until he turns 18 years old. The object is to keep him away from the bad environment that contribute to his wrongdoing. So, ang sinasabi po dito is, pag yung person or yung bata is less than 17 years old, hindi pa siya pwedeng dalhin sa jail. So, ano po ba yung alternative ways na pwedeng gawin sa kanya? Pwede po siyang dalhin sa kanya mga kamag-anak or tinatawag na nating relatives sa school or sa boys town or orphanage. Yun po yung sinasabi dito sa committal to the care of a fit person. Next po natin is yung remission or release on license or parole. Remission is the reduction of the term of a prison sentence, usually due to good behavior or conduct. Release on license means that the prison may be released at the halfway point of their fixed sentence and spend the remaining part of the sentence on license, during which they must follow strict condition. Ano po ba yung sinasabi dito? Ang sinasabi naman dito sa remission or release on license or parole, dahil sa good behavior or conduct na ginagawa ng isang person sa loob ng jail, nagkakaroon siya ng pag-asa na mabigyan ng tinatawag nating parole. So, hindi ko na papalawakin yung about sa parole kasi po, merong reporter na naka-designated dyan. Sila yung magdi-discuss kung ano po ba yung parole. So, this form of temporary release allow offenders to reintegrate into society and rebuild family ties, kumbaga. Next po is yung community service. Pag sinabi natin community service, involves rendering unpaid labor by the offender with assignment. Kumbaga, ito yung trabaho na walang bayad. Doon sa mga offenders or sa mga person nga na nakagawa ng hindi naman masyadong malalang crime or something. For example is yung nag-void sila ng curfew, ganun, or nagtapo ng basura, nag-littering, etc. So there will be punishment sa pamamagitan ng community service instead na dali natin sila sa jail. Tapos dahil din sa community service, kumbaga, nababawasan yung gastos ng city government, syempre, kasi hindi sila nagbabayad dun sa mga person na nagka-conduct ng community service dahil pinagbabayaran lang nila kung ano yung na-commit nila or ano yung ginawa nila. Next is yung house arrest, home confinement, or home detention. Requires offender to remain within the confines of the home during the specific times and to adhere to strict curfew. additional condition as restriction on visitor, the provision of drugs and alcohol use, offender is normally allowed to leave for work and reasons such as grocery shopping, community service assignment, and doctor's appointments. In progress, contrary, the success of house arrest program has been enhanced by the use of electronic monitoring device directed toward the offender's whereabouts. So when we say house arrest, home confinement, or home detention, correct me if I'm wrong, kumbaga, para siyang yung nila-lockdown yung isang bahay or isang family dun lang sa loob ng bahay nila, hindi sila pinapayagan lumabas, etc. Papayagan lang silang lumabas pag they will go to work or grocery shopping, etc. Then, hindi sila pwedeng lumabas kasi mamomonitor sila. Kagaya nga nasabi dito, they will be monitoring device directed to the offenders or about para malalaman ng authorities kung lumalabas ba sila or what. Next is yung day reporting centers. These are non-residential location which offenders most visit every day to participate in program activities and to work out a schedule detailing their activities outside the centers. Offenders also required to maintain frequently phone communication with center staff and submit to random drug and alcohol testing. So that's the day reporting centers, kumbaga. Parang yung pinaka presinto or center ng mga nakaka-commit ng mga minor cases. Then especially dapat meron silang magandang communication dun sa mga staff ng centers. Sabi nga dito, diba, to submit to random drug and alcohol testing. Next po is yung residential community correction. Residential community correction, this include halfway house pre-release centers, community works treatment centers, and restitution centers. Residents may leave either part-time or full-time such centers, depending on condition set forth by the court. These types of center may be used alternatives to sending an offender to a jail or maybe transitional stop for offender just released from incarceration to determine if they are ready to return to society. So, ang purpose naman is to help the offenders return to the communities, kumbaga maging better members sila ng communities or society. Kumbaga, ito yung alternative way kaysa dalhin sila sa mga kulungan or kaysa i-prison sila, di ba? Kasi nga, pag dinala pa sila sa kulungan or kukulong pa sila, mas lalong lalala yung problem natin sa overcrowding. Alam din naman po natin lahat na dito sa atin sa Philippines, hindi lang sa Philippines, na sa buong Asia nga po, na pagdating sa prison facilities is nagkakaroon ng problem na overcrowding. So, ito din yung offenders that meet acceptance criteria are placed in residential program instead of prison nga po. So, that's all my part. The next reporter po is si Mr. C. Thank you.
The lack of alternative solutions to incarceration is a contributing factor for prison overcrowding. There are limited opportunities for early release or substituting more lenient punishment in place of imprisonment. Some reason why there is an overcrowding in prison is because of lack of alternative solution. Just like those people who committed a light offenses or non-custodial offenses should not be brought into prison. Instead, they should just punish them like community service fines to prevent the prison from overcrowding. The easiest way, though not necessarily the ideal solution to prison overcrowding, is to build more prison. It is also very expensive. Still, many countries build more prison by converting unused facilities or expand current prison to add capacity. A lot of us may think that the easiest way to solve the prison overcrowding is to build more prison, but not knowing, in reality, it is very expensive. Also, it consider the place, the situation where the prison will be built, and especially the surrounding. This is an example of an overcrowded prison. Next is PRI. PRI stands for Penal Reform International. Penal Reform International is an international non-governmental organization working on penal and criminal justice reform worldwide. Introduced a 10-point plan to reduce prison overcrowding. The PRI developed a 10-point plan to reduce prison overcrowding to provide guidance to policymakers on how to address prison overcrowding and mitigate its harmful consequences. It means that the 10-point plan focuses on ways of reducing overcrowding in prisons around the world. Overcrowding or congestion, as it is called in some countries, is the biggest single problem facing prison systems, with consequences that can at worst be life-threatening and at best prevent prisons from fulfilling their proper function. What are the 10-point plan of the Penal Reform International? The first one is to improve public opinion. It is to give an awareness to the public about the prison situation, just like news TV. And the second one is improve access and coordination within the criminal justice system. It is the improving of the criminal justice system for public, just like increasing public access to the police, court, and prisons engenders public confidence and transparency. Number 3, invest in crime prevention and crime reduction. Problem-solving partnerships between police and other public agencies, business and community can produce effective plans to reduce the risk factors that lie behind many forms of crimes as drug misuse, family difficulties, school failure, and employment. It says that invest more in planning of how to reduce and control crimes that lies in the society by working with the other agencies, business, and to your community. Number 4. Divert minor cases from the CJS. Putting minor offender into a treatment or care program different to other offenders' rehabilitation, just like schools or public schools, and educate them to prevent them from being a complete law offender. And it is also a way to stop the overcrowding in prison. Number 5. Reduce pretrial detention. In some countries, as many as 75% of the prison population are pretrial detainees. They said that by reducing a pretrial detention may help to lessen or prevent a possible overcrowding in prison. Number 6. Develop constructive non-custodial sentences. It means that developing a non-custodial sentences like community service for offenders who are apprehended for non-violent crimes or those crimes that are closely related to their economic and social disadvantage in society is also a way to prevent an overcrowding in prison. Number 8. Develop a special arrangement for youth offenders that keep them out of prison. One way to avoid the overcrowding in prison is by developing a program for minor offenders, a special program to prevent them ending up in prison. Number 9. Treat rather than punish drug addicts and mentally disordered offenders. It is also a way to avoid the overcrowding in prison by putting drug users into the rehabilitation center rather than putting them into jail, especially those people who have mental problems. Number 10. Ensure the system is fair to all. This is also a way to prevent the prison from overcrowding by giving a fair, balanced trial to rich, poor, and middle classes. Basically speaking, everyone must be equal in the eyes of the law. Extinction of criminal liability. What is criminal liability? Criminal liability is the responsibility for any illegal behavior that causes harm or damage to someone or something. A total extinction of criminal liability means that the entire penalty is extinguished and there is no more criminal liability. Under Article 89 of the Revised Penal Code, Act Number 3815, as amended, criminal liability totally extinguished under the following circumstances: death of convict by service of sentence, offender has been imprisoned for a period prescribed by the law, by amnesty, which completely extinguished penalty and all effects. An amnesty is the act of the sovereign power granted oblivion or a general pardon for a past offense to a group or class of people, rarely an individual. It extinguishes criminal liability but not civil liability. absolute pardon, an act of grace proceeding from the power entrusted with the execution of the law. By prescription of the crimes, refers to the laws of the state to prosecute after the lapse of a certain period. The period for the prescription will start from the day the crime was discovered by the offended party or authorities, and is interrupted if an information or complaint is filed, and will run again when the proceedings terminate, without acquittal or conviction, or is unjustifiable stop through no fault of the offender. By prescription of penalty, refers to the laws of the right of the state to execute the final sentence after the lapse of a certain time. The period of prescription of penalties runs from the date when the offender evaded the service of his sentence, and is interrupted if the defendant voluntarily gives up or is captured or should go to some foreign country with which the Philippines has no extradition treaty, or commits other crime before the end of the period to prescribe. By marriage of the offended woman, as provided in Article 344 of the Revised Penal Code, marriage of the offender with the offended woman after the commission of any of the crimes of rape, seduction, abduction, or acts of lasciviousness, as provided in Article 344, must be contracted by the offender in good faith. Hence, marriage contracted only to avoid criminal liability is devoid of legal effects. Justifying circumstances. What is the meaning of justifying circumstances? Are instances where a person acts in accordance with law, so that person is deemed not to have violated the law and therefore has no criminal liability and civil liability. For justifying circumstances to be accepted, it must be pleaded and proven in court. Self-defense of Article 11, Paragraph 1. Anyone who acts in defense of his person or rights, as of chastity, property, and honor, even in crime of libel. Defense of relative. In defense of his spouse, ascendants, descendants, legitimate or adopted brothers, sisters, or affinity in the same degree, and those of consanguinity within fourth civil degree, and in case the provocation was given by the person attacked, that the one making the defense had no part therein, according to Article 11, Paragraph 2. Defense of a stranger. In defense or a right of a stranger, and that the person defending be not induced by revenge, resentment, or other motive, according to Article 11, Paragraph 3. Fulfillment of duty, or in the lawful exercise of a right or office, Article 11, Paragraph 5. The injury caused or the offense committed is the necessary consequences of the due performance of such right or office. Obedience to superior order, issued by a superior for some lawful purpose, of Article 11, Paragraph 6.
Prescription of crimes, according to Article 9 of the Revised Penal Code. Prescription of crimes is the forfeiture or the loss of the right of the state to prosecute the offender after the lapse of a certain period of time fixed by the law. The period of prescription for the prosecution of a crime or a violation of city ordinances and special laws shall depend on the duration of the penalty meted out by the laws for such violation. Note that the term prescription shall not run when the offender is absent from the Philippine archipelago. The first is crime punishable by death, reclusion perpetua, or reclusion temporal, shall prescribe in 20 years. Second is crimes punishable by other afflictive penalties, shall prescribe in 15 years. The third one is those punishable by the correctional penalty shall prescribe in 5 years, with the exception of those punishable by arresto mayor, which shall prescribe in 5 years. Crime of libel shall be prescribed in 1 year. The fifth one, the offenses or oral defamation or insulting and slander by deed, which is false spreading rumor, shall prescribe in 6 months. The sixth one, light offenses shall be prescribed in 2 months. And lastly, the seventh one, when the penalty prescribed by law is a compound one, the highest penalty shall be made the basis, according to Republic Act 4661, which is an act shortening the prescriptive period for libel and other similar offenses, amending for the purpose of Article 90 of Revised Penal Code. Prescription of penalties under Article 92 of the RPC. Prescription of penalties imposed by final sentence shall prescribe as follows. Number 1. Death and reclusion perpetua, which is 20 years. Number 2. Other afflictive penalties, which is 15 years. Number 3. Correctional penalties, which is 10 years with the exception of the penalty of the arresto mayor, which is 5 years. Number 4. Light penalties, which is 1 year. Computation of prescription of penalties under Article 93 of the Revised Penal Code. The prescription of penalties shall commence to run from the date when the culprit should evade the service of his sentence, and it shall be interrupted if the defendant should give himself up, be captured, should go to some foreign country with which this government has no extradition treaty, or should commit another crime before the expiration of the period of prescription. Under Article 94 of the Revised Penal Code, partial extinction of criminal liability is extinguished partially by these following conditions. Number 1. Criminal liability is extinguished partially by conditional pardon. Number 2. Criminal liability is extinguished partially by commutation of sentence. And lastly, criminal liability is extinguished partially for good conduct allowances, which the culprit may earn while he is undergoing preventive imprisonment or serving his sentence, amended by Republic Act 10592, which is an act amending Article 29, 94, 97, 98, and 99 of Act Number 3815 as amended, otherwise known as the Revised Penal Code.
Exempted circumstance, Article 12 of Revised Penal Code. Circumstance for non-immutability or those grounds for exemption from punishment. Because there is one thing in the agent of the crime, any of the conditions that make the act voluntarily. Basis on the lack of any of the elements that make the act omission voluntary, like freedom, intelligence, intent, or due care. Obligation incurred by a person granted conditional pardon. Any person who has been granted conditional pardon shall incur the obligation of the complying strictly with the condition imposed therein. Otherwise, his non-compliance with any of the conditions specified shall result in the revocation of the pardon. And the provision of Article 159 of the Revised Penal Code shall be applied to him. Effect of commutation of sentence. The commutation of the original sentence for another of different length and nature shall have the legal effect of substituting the latter in the place of the former, Article 96 of the Revised Penal Code. The exemption from punishment. In the Philippines as well as in most countries of the modern world, the state recognized several circumstances in which a person who has transgressed the law will not suffer its consequence. There are two classes of injuries caused by an offense, like social injury and personal injury. Social injury is produced by the disturbance and the alarm resulting from the offense, and the personal injury is caused by the victim of the crime, who suffered by damage either to his person, to his property, and to his honor or to her chastity. Exempting circumstance is the exempted or the underage, like person over 9 years of age and under 15 years old, unless he has acted with discernment. The person under 9 years of age, this was repealed by Republic Act 9344, an act established a comprehensive juvenile justice and welfare system. A child 15 years of age or under at the time of the commission of the offense shall be exempt from criminal liability. However, the child shall be subjected to an intervention program. A child above 15 years old but below 18 years old of age shall likewise be exempt from criminal liability and be subjected to an intervention program unless he or she act with the discernment. The example of exempting circumstance is when the father is have a gun always under his table and don't place the gun in the safe place, and her or his child open the table and play the gun and accidentally pulled the trigger and accidentally killed her mother. So the liability of the case is his father because his father don't place the gun in the safety place so that the child get the gun and play and accidentally kill her mother, and the liability of the and the liable of the case is his father.
Pardon and defects of pardon by the president. Number 1, a pardon shall not restore the right to hold public office or the right to suffrage, except when any or both such rights is or are expressly restored by the terms of the pardon. So yung sinasabi dito, kahit na binigyan na ng grant yung may taong may sala, di pa din siya makakabalik sa office or sa kanyang katungkulan. Depende na lang kung nakasaad sa pardon niya na pwede na. Karamihan dito sa nabibigyan ng pardon ay government official, bukod doon president lang ang nagrarant ng pardon. Number 2, it shall not exempt the culprit from the payment of the civil indemnity. Ito yung hindi exception yung criminal unless nabayaran niya yung payment. Constitutional limitations on the exercise of the pardoning power. Limitations provided under the Constitution are: no pardon may be granted in impeachment cases. So dito, sa example, yung government official is may impeach na. Bawal na siyang mabigyan ng pardon. Number 2, no pardon may be granted when other provided under the Constitution, especially Section 5, Article Number 11, which provides that no pardon, amnesty, parole, or suspension of sentence for violation of election laws, rules, and regulations shall be granted by the President without the favorable recommendation of COMELEC. Dito, sabi dito, hindi daw mabibigyan o magagantipalaan ang ng pardon o parole or suspension pag hindi na-aprobahan ng COMELEC. Number 3, it may be granted after conviction by final judgment. Ito naman, mabibigyan na ito pagtapos ng final judgment or judgment of conviction. Mabibigyan na ito ng granted. Pardon by the chief executive. Number 1, extinguishes the criminal liability of the offender. So, dito, a person is liable or responsible for a crime when he or she has acted with a criminal intent, as opposed to acting accidentally or lacking the ability to act deliberately. Number 2, include civil liability which the offender must pay. So dito, kahit ano pang ginawang illegal or criminal intent ng offender, obligation niya pa ding magbayad. Number 3, granted only after conviction and may be extended to any of the offenders. Ito naman, mabibigyan ng grant pag na-declare na guilty ang offenders sa anumang kanilang criminal offenses. The next is pardon by the offended party. Number 1, does not extinguish the criminal liability of the offender. Dito naman, kung sa chief executive ini-extinguish nila ang criminal liability, sa offended party naman ay hindi. Number 2, offended party can waive the civil liability which the offender must pay. So dito, pag yung biktima ay humihingi ng kahit anong request sa'yo, tulad ng pagbayad mo ng hospital bill, pera o kung anumang pangangailangan niya, kailangan mo pa din itong bayaran. Number 3, pardon should be given before the institution of criminal prosecution and must extend to both offenders. O dito, bago i-undertake sa prosecution ang mga offenders, bibigyan muna sila ng pardon.